ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु हृदयेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नष्टके। सो रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 13 चैप्टर इज एंटाइटल्ड ब्रह्मा स्टीलिंग द बॉयज एंड कैप्स टेक्स्ट नंबर 43 राइट एवं एतेषु भेदेषु क्षीरं धत्वा स्व आत्मभू सत्ता के कतरे नेति ज्ञातुं नस्ते कथञ्चन। एवं एतेषु भेदेषु क्षीरं धत्वा स्व आत्मभू सत्ता के कतरे नेति ज्ञातुं नस्ते कथञ्चन। एवं एतेषु भेदेषु क्षीरं धत्वा स्व आत्मभू सत्ता के कतरे नेति ज्ञातुं नस्ते कथञ्चन। इन दिस वे एतेषु भेदेषु बिटवीन दिस बॉयज हु आर एग्जिस्टिंग सेपरेटली चिरम फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम ध्वत्वा आफ्टर थिंकिंग स ही आत्मभू लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा सत्या रियल के हु कतरे हु न आर नॉट इति दस ज्ञातुम टू अंडरस्टैंड न नॉट इस्ते वॉज एबल कथंचन इन एनी वे एट ऑल। ट्रांसलेशन एंड पर्पोर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस श्री भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। Translation. Thus Lord Brahma, thinking and thinking for a long time, tried to distinguish between those two sets of boys who were each separately existing. He tried to understand who was real and who was not real, but he could not understand at all. Please repeat. Thus Lord Brahma, thinking and thinking for a long time, tried to distinguish between those two sets of boys who are each separately existing. He tried to understand who was real and who was not real, but he could not understand at all. Purport. Brahma was puzzled. The original boys and caps were still sleeping as I kept them, he thought. But another set is here playing with Krishna. How has this happened? Brahma could not grasp what was happening. Which boys was real and which were not real? Brahma was unable to come to any definite conclusion. He pondered the matter for long while. How can there be two sets of caps and boys at the same time? Have the boys and caps here been created by Krishna, or has Krishna created the boys lying asleep, or are both merely creations of Krishna? Brahma thought about the subject in many different ways. After I go to the cave and see that the boys and caps are still there, does Krishna go take them away and put them here so that I come here and see them? And does Krishna then take them from here and put them there? Brahma could not figure out how there could be two sets of caps and cowherd boys exactly alike, although thinking and thinking, he could not understand at all. Mukam karati vachalam pungul langhayate giring yat kripa tamaham mande sri guru dinatarinam paramananda madhavam sri chaitanya sharanam. Hare Krishna. So, I am very happy again to be here in ISKCON Kanpur, from Mayapur to Kanpur. So, tomorrow is a very big festival. So, today's topic is not a new topic for you, and is a very famous topic, the Brahma, the topmost living entity in this material universe, is bewildered. Here Prabhupada has written, Brahma was puzzled. Because this is the nature of this world. We are all puzzled. And Srimad Bhagavatam also explains that Krishna's pastimes are very difficult to understand. Muihanti jat suraya. At the beginning it is said, even the demigods become bewildered. Whatever has been spoken is exhibited now. Practical, some was theoretical explanation, now practical exhibition by Sukadeva Goswami to show all of us how Krishna can bewilder everyone, including Brahma. So if Brahma is bewildered, we can be bewildered or not? Some people say, we are already bewildered, Prabhu. So we are already bewildered. For us to understand is very, very difficult, the pastimes of Krishna. Because Krishna does his pastime by yogamaya potency. And we are covered over by mahamaya potency. And Krishna also says in Bhagavad Gita, avajananti mangmura manusim tanumasritam param bhavam ajananta. Krishna has transcendental nature. And we are conditioned souls, and when Krishna appears in the human form, we think Krishna is also like human. So understanding Lord is difficult, but understanding Krishna is most difficult. Because Krishna, when he comes, he does all kinds of activities. And certain kinds of activities which are very controversial by nature also. Right? Controversy. The famous, you can become famous by controversy only. And Krishna is most famous, that's why he does most controversial activities. Who comes at the front page of newspaper? Those who are, other people also come, but those who are controversial definitely come to the front page. So these pastimes, especially this pastime, Krishna is teaching through Brahma that don't try to understand me by your own endeavor. It's not possible. So Brahma is seeing these pastimes every day. Right? Krishna says that I appear in my original form once in a day of Brahma. So this Brahma, I heard, he has already completed his 50 years. Golden Jubilee is over. ISKCON has Golden Jubilee, Brahma has Golden Jubilee. We are in golden years, right? And we also heard that when Mahaprabhu appeared, till next 10,000 years is the golden era. So we are in a society who has completed the golden jubilee. We are in this Brahmanda, the creator of that Brahmanda, Brahma has also completed golden jubilee. The incarnation under whose direction we are managing our life as a devotee is also golden, golden avatar. And the age which are in this Kali Yuga is also golden age. Everything is golden, except us, right? But expectation is that we should also be golden. And for that, golden opportunity is also provided by Srila Prabhupada. Right? So golden opportunities are there, golden avatar is there, golden age is there, golden jubilee is there, everything is golden, but we have to make the right choice in our life, to make our life golden. So coming to the point of Brahma, Brahma has completed his 50 years. And if every day Krishna appears, so how many times he has seen this first time? How many times? Don't calculate. I know you are good in mathematics, but many times. Even after seeing many times, he is bewildered. Right or wrong? I was hearing that Jiva Goswami has explained, Krishna comes in every day with his Vrindavan pastimes. But his pastimes become complete. It's completely manifested when Brahma, that day when Brahma is 50 years old. It's not that Krishna manifests his pastime completely. It becomes most complete when Brahma is 50 years old. Just like that. Come, then like that. Top. Although Krishna comes every day, but Krishna comes on the 50th anniversary of Brahma, he becomes most magnanimous. And he shows his pastimes in the most complete form. So we are very, very fortunate. And Brahma's life is also fortunate. We are all bewildered by the Mahamaya potency, but Brahma is bewildered by Krishna. He is very fortunate. Just like Lord Shiva, in Mayapur the topic is now that Lord Shiva wanted to see the Mohini Murti. He saw many forms, but he was not happy after that. He wanted to see the Mohini Murti of the Lord. And when he saw the Mohini Murti, Shiva was bewildered, attracted. But it all happens by the will of the Lord. Brahma Sampradaya devotees, not our Brahma Madhya Gauriya Sampradaya, that Brahma Madhya Sampradaya people don't accept this chapter of Bhagavatam. You know that? He said it was added. It was not part of original Bhagavatam. They think, how come? Our Acharya will be bewildered. Then we should not read Bhagavad Gita also. The whole Bhagavad Gita should be discarded, right? How come Arjuna was bewildered, who is the eternal associate of Krishna? And we should not read Srimad Bhagavatam also. How come Parikshit Maharaj, who is also eternal associate of Krishna, got bewildered? Then everything should be rejected. But Krishna manifests his mercy through his own people. Through his own people. Arjuna cannot be bewildered. But he got bewildered by the desire of Krishna. We get bewildered by the Mahamaya potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But Arjuna got bewildered by the will of the Lord. Parikshit Maharaj could not control his senses because he was thirsty. And he has put the snake, bear snake, around Samikrishi's, right? Parikshit Maharaj can do this. But he did that. We can understand that Parikshit Maharaj cannot do this. When Sukadeva Goswami was speaking Srimad Bhagavatam for 7 days and 7 nights, he never complained, I am thirsty. The same Parikshit Maharaj, who could not tolerate the thirst for some time, but he was not feeling any thirst or hunger for 7 days and 7 nights. By that we can understand the level of Parikshit Maharaj. But same Parikshit Maharaj, because of his thirst, he put dead snake around the neck of Samikrishi. By this we can understand it was the desire of the Supreme Personality of Godhead to reveal Srimad Bhagavatam through Parikshit Maharaj. In the same way, Krishna wants to show that my pastimes are by nature bewildering. And he wants to show that through his own person. A great person teaches the lesson not through somebody who is not his own man. And Krishna is doing that because of this reason. Although Brahma is a pure devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he is getting bewildered by the yogamaya potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that is one part. Other part is, Krishna is performing this pastime to fulfill the desire of Brajavasis. The Brajavasis, mainly the mothers, elderly gopis, they wanted to have Krishna as their own son. And the cows also wanted Krishna to be their own calves. Right? But Krishna, by one pastime, in one stroke, he achieved so many things. So in this 1 year of Brahma's bewilderment, Brahma Vimohan Leela, Krishna was acting as the son of the gopis and also the calves of the cows. And Krishna was meticulously perfect. Is too meticulous. Not only the form, So having the same form is also difficult. In this world, one person cannot be similar with another man. All are different. But Krishna exactly manifested himself like the cowherd boys and also the calves. But only having the form is not enough. Same nature has to be manifested. Otherwise mother will think, what kind of son is that? That he is acting differently. The same nature, same mind, same intelligence, same memory, exactly same. Cowherd voice as it is, right? No change, not only the form, exactly the same, other things also. Externals, internals, all are same. And by seeing that, Brahma got bewildered. He thought that he wants to bewilder Krishna, but in the process, he became bewildered. And he started thinking, he is doing mathematics, no, permutation combinations. So he was doing a lot of combinations. Whether this set of cowherd boys and calves are the real one, or whatever I have stolen is the real one. And he was also thinking, maybe one set. So when I am going to the caves, Krishna is taking the boys there. And when I am coming here, before I come, he takes all the cows and calves and cowherd boys here. Just thinking like that. And he was thinking, which is the real one? My one is the real one, or this one is the real one? Or both are real one? But in the process, he could not come to a conclusion. What to talk about Brahma? Balaram also could not understand. For 1 year, few days before, when Balaram saw in Govardhan that the cows with their own calves, they're there. But at the down, the Krishna who manifested himself of the calves, they are grown up. 1 year means grown up, no? By seeing those calves at the down, the cows left their own calves, newly born calves, and started running from the top of the hill to the down of the hill. By seeing that, Balaram could smell something different is happening. And then Krishna revealed to him. So Brahma was bewildered. Balaram was bewildered. This is the nature of the pastimes of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Krishna's yogamaya potency can cover up everyone, including Krishna himself. So Krishna, if he knows that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, if that bhav is there, then he cannot act like a son. He cannot act like a lover. He can act like a cowherd boy. So that remembrance or that ahankar, the real ego, that I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead, if that is there, it is very, very difficult or impossible to enact or perform the pastimes in Vrindavan. So therefore Krishna takes shelter of the yogamaya potency. By the yogamaya potency, all the devotees of Vrindavan, they forget that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and Krishna also forgets. Thus he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the beauty of Vrindavan. So they are all forgetful about Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We are also forgetful. that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then you may say, oh, this world and Golok Vrindavan is same Prabhuji. Both are forgetful. But here we are forgetful because of our own desire. Krishna boli je jib Bhagavan cha kare nikatastha mayatare jhapatiya dhare. You know this verse, right? We desired to enjoy separately from Krishna. And that's why Krishna covers up by his Mohamaya potency. But the devotees of Vrindavan, they want to be intimately together with Krishna. So therefore, Krishna covers up by Jogamaya potency. So that is the difference between Mohamaya potency and Jogamaya potency. Jogamaya potency unites the soul, unites the devotees with Krishna. But Mohamaya potency separates us from Krishna. That is the difference. It's a big difference. But actually there is one potency only. It acts in a different way. Just like electricity. Prabhupada said, electricity is the same. When it is connected with the heater, it becomes hot. When it is connected with the refrigerator, it becomes cold. So is electricity hot or cold? Depends how it is connected. In the same way, the same potency, Krishna has only, Krishna, although Krishna has unlimited potency, but Krishna has only one potency, acts in unlimited ways. So that is the second lesson we should learn. Then how we will understand Krishna? So Brahma could not understand. Even Balaram also forgot. So what to talk about us? They are only covered over by Jogamaya potency. But we are covered over by Mohamaya potency. And Krishna is covered over by Jogamaya potency. So two potency covering. So how we can see Krishna? Possible? What do you think? It's possible to see Krishna? Sei sei Ishwar tattva bujhibare pare Ishwarer kripale hoyeche jahare. We can see the Supreme Personality of Godhead only by His causeless mercy. By our own endeavor, we cannot see Krishna. That's why Rupa Goswami has explained in Nectar of Devotion, Suddha Bhakti is Sudurlava. One of the symptoms of pure devotional service is, it is Sudurlava. Sudurlava means, one is Sulabh. We have Sulabh Bhojanalai, we have Sulabh Sauchalai. Sulabh means very cheap, easily available. Right? From Sulabh to Durlabh. Durlabh means rare. And Sudurlabh means very rare. Suddha Bhakti is very rare to achieve. Why? Rupa Goswami explains two reasons for that. Number one, the Lord doesn't want to give it. And number two, we cannot achieve it. What a strange combination. So Krishna doesn't want to give it, and we cannot achieve it by our own endeavor. So where is the hope? Hope is there. Unless hope is there, we are hopeless case, right? So hope is there. And what is the hope? Hope is that if we take shelter of the pure devotees. Krishna cannot give it. How Krishna can give? He doesn't have it. Shuddha bhakti is the property of the pure devotees, not Krishna. Everything belongs to Krishna except pure devotee, except pure devotional service. So therefore, importance of devotees is given so much stress. And that has to be understood. Our tendency is to have direct access. Direct access. So, there is a story in South India, Varada Raj. Varada Raj was served by devotee. What's his name? I forgot the name. Kanchipurna. So Kanchipurna not only used to serve, his service was to fan Varada Raj. And he used to talk to Varada Raj also. Very good, no? We need devotees like that. So if any management issue comes, we can talk to him. Then we'll come to a right decision. And generally Lord speaks to pure devotees. So Kanchipurna used to speak. But there was a devotee, he was taking shelter of Kanchipurna. So that devotee asked Kanchipurna, asked Varada Raj, that whether I can go back home, back to Godhead or not. So Kanchipurna asked Varada Raj, that this person is asking whether he can go back home, back to Godhead or not. He said, yes, he will definitely go back. Yes, so by hearing that, that person was very happy. So after asking this question, Kanchipurna started thinking that why not I also ask? Then he asked, my dear Lord, you told that person will go back home, back to Godhead. So what is my situation? Whether I can go back home, back to Godhead or not? So Varada Raj said, no, you cannot go back home, back to Godhead. He said, my dear Lord, that person is able to go, I am serving you. He said, yes, I reciprocate according to you. You serve me, I accept your service. You want to talk to me, I talk to you. But it doesn't mean you can go back home, back to Godhead. No, no chance, zero chance, 0%. He said, why? He said, you are not serving the Vaishnavas. You are only serving me. So then he said, okay, take your fan. So I am going. So he came to Srirangam area. I think he started serving Mahapurna. But Kanchipurna was very famous. He came in disguise as a normal cowherd boy. And he started serving Mahapurna. He used to take care of his cows, take care of his other things in disguise. So one day there was heavy rain. And he came very late. So Mahapurna thought he is having wet clothes, I should give some dry clothes to him. So he came to his room. But that time Kanchipurna was wearing his original cloth, means as Kanchipurna, because he could not dry up his own cloth as a coward boy. As soon as Mahapurna entered in his room, he saw Kanchipurna. He said, oh Kanchipurna, you are worshipable to me. I should worship you, but you are serving me like a menial servant. So he explained the whole thing, why he is doing that. He said, no, go back to Kanchipuram and start serving Varada Raj. So he came back. Then he asked, now, my dear Lord, I can go back home, back to Godhead. He said, now you can go back home, back to Godhead, because you served my pure devotee, Mahapurna. So this philosophy is not should be taken mechanically, it should be realized. Krishna only reciprocates through his devotees. Direct access is the defect of the conditioned soul. We think being close means more mercy, right? That's why people like to be close to the great personalities. I am close to him. Because if you are close to some great person, you get a lot of benefits, right? Lot of benefits. But these kind of benefits have no value in our spiritual journey. The real benefit is pure devotional service. That mood has to be cultivated. That's why we have entered into this glorious movement. What is the purpose? If that purpose is clear, then life will become perfect. But sometimes we forget. Just like Brahma forgot who is Krishna. We also forget. We are forgetful by nature. So in due course of time, the purpose we entered into this movement, we forget. And venture for something else according to our nature. So therefore, we have to be very, very careful. And we have to understand what is the goal of our life. Mahaprabhu has said we have two goals in life. Attain Krishna Prem and give Krishna Prem to others. Nothing else is there. And that is the purpose of this Hare Krishna movement. Prabhupada has established this Hare Krishna movement ISKCON so that those who will join ISKCON, they will get the love of Godhead and they will distribute this love of Godhead to others. This has to be remembered. But we desire so many other things according to our nature. And how we can get love of Godhead? How? Tell me, I am in ignorance, please enlighten me. How we can get love of Godhead? Shuddha bhakti is independent. Any process will not work. We think by chanting the holy name we will get love of Godhead. By hearing Srimad Bhagavatam we get love of Godhead. By worshipping the deities, you get love of Godhead. What is the tendency? Tendency is that by our own endeavor, we'll get love of Godhead. That is the most difficult problem we face. Because we are coming from a background where we achieve things by our own endeavor. And think we are also from very nice background. We have achieved so many things and those who are most successful, they think we are so successful and we'll also become successful here. Doesn't work. External materialistic achievements has nothing to do with pure devotional service. That's why Prabhupada started this new bhakta program. Actually, we are all new bhaktas. Some people think, oh, we are new bhaktas, now we are senior. Why? Because new bhakta training period is over, now we are real devotees of ISKCON now. New bhakta period is over. But we have to understand, we are new bhakta till we enter into the spiritual world. We are all new bhaktas. As soon as we start thinking we are senior, problem started. Right? That is a symptom. When you start thinking we are senior, then you have to understand that there is a symptom, no? Symptom of cancer. So these are the symptoms of cancer in our spiritual life. We are senior. We should be respected. How many years? 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, we are senior. This is a disease. So that disease has to be recognized and should be taken care of. And by our own endeavor, we cannot get love of Godhead. It's an experience. It's not a product. Product can be bought, product can be achieved. But Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhya Kabu Nai, Savanadi Siddha Chitte Karho Udai. Udai means it has to be awakened. It's not that it has to be manufactured. Heart is not a manufacturing unit. It's already there. So it has to be uncovered. So uncovering is done by our humility. Hearing has to be there, but Suddha Chitte. Suddha Chitte means with humility, with humble state. So that humility comes when we serve the devotees. Very important. And serve those devotees who are not so favorable to us. Then that will make us more humble. If I love someone, adore someone, serving them is easy. If I don't like someone, serving them will be more difficult. And that will make us pure. Just like charity. Giving money, no? Giving money purifies the wealth. Giving money in charity. How much you should give? If you like to give 100 rupees, for example, 100 rupees is okay, comfortable, no problem. But what pinches you? Itna chala gaya. So then you'll get the benefit. If charity does not pinch you, then you'll not get love of God. Okay? In the same way, Vaishnav Seva that pinches you, purifies you. The point I am to make, in order to get love of Godhead, we have to come out from the comfort zone. That is the point I am to make. Comfort zone is the zone to decline. We have to come out from the comfort zone. Spiritual life is not a life of comfort. We are the warrior of Hare Krishna movement. We should be always alert. A soldier is always alert. Anytime attack can take place, right? In the same way, in our Krishna conscious life, there is always a chance of attack. Maya attacks those who are advancing in Krishna consciousness. If someone is a comfort zone, Maya will not attack. He said, Mera hi hai na? It's my man, why to attack? Someone who is going through difficulty in life, that is one of the symptoms that is advancing in Krishna consciousness. If there is no challenge, chalta hai, chalti ka naam gaadi chal raha hai, means nothing is happening in his life. So, when you advance in Krishna consciousness, Maya becomes active. And when you are not advancing, Maya will not give so much importance. So, chalta hai. Just like when before Krishna appeared, Kamsa was in a passive mode. Right? So Brajavasis had nice time, peaceful time, no disturbance. As soon as Krishna appeared in Gokul, Kamsa was active mode. Very active. So it means wherever Maya attacks, you have to understand Krishna is there. If Krishna is not there, Maya will not attack. Why will attack? So therefore, when we are very serious about advancing in Krishna consciousness, we should be always alert because Maya will be attacking us. We should not think we have a comfortable life and we will attend the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is a utopian world. Does not exist. Anyone who achieves success in spiritual life went through trouble. So trouble is a part of life. For the materialistic also, people also, for spiritualist also. And people ask, then Prabhuji, why? Why to become devotee? If problem will be there, we become devotees because problem will not be there. But the difference between devotees facing problem and those who are not devotees facing problem. Just like Yogamaya, Mahamaya. For outside people, those who go through trouble, they become away, more away from Krishna. But for the devotees, more problems, they come more closer to Krishna. The biggest problem Vajavasi is faced during Indra attacked Vrindavan. The greatest attack happened. And that time, they became most close to Krishna. That is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. An advanced devotee takes the problems in his life as a step. Step for what? Stepping stone to achieve the lotus feet of Krishna. So more problems come, quickly he achieves the lotus feet of Krishna. Because more steps, no? There are a lot of steps. Between us and Krishna, there are a lot of steps. So more problems come, that becomes one step, two steps. So more problems, so we quickly achieve the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the mentality of the pure devotee, and that consciousness has to be cultivated. And in this pastime, Krishna is showing that how he reciprocates with his devotees. He reciprocated with Brahma, he reciprocated with the cows, he reciprocated with the gopis, he reciprocated with the cowherd boys, he reciprocated with Agasura. In that way, he reciprocated in so many ways, because Krishna is very, very expert in reciprocating with other living entities. We also should be very reciprocal. Reciprocation is the symptom of love. And no reciprocation is the symptom of selfishness. So if you want to love someone, we have to reciprocate. Some people say, oh, मैं बहुत प्यार करता हूँ भगवान से. कुछ करता नहीं लेकिन दिल में प्रेम है. ऐसे नहीं होगा. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू लव, लव मीन्स यू हैव टू बी रेसिप्रोकेटिव. रेसिप्रोकेशन इज द सिम्टम ऑफ लव. सो कृष्णा लव्स एवरी वन, दैट्स वाई ही रेसिप्रोकेट्स विथ एवरी वन. दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ कृष्णा. एंड बाई हिज वृंदावन पास्ट टाइम ही इज एग्जिबिटिंग दैट beautiful nature of him. So we should learn from Krishna and try to take shelter of his lotus feet so that our life will become perfect by his causeless mercy. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Any question? Koi prashna hai? अनुवाद कैसा हुआ? हिंदी अनुवाद अच्छा हुआ? ठीक है, बोलिए प्रभु जी.
हरे कृष्णा. थैंक यू रमेश प्रभु जी फॉर वंडरफुल एक्सप्लेनिंग हाउ वी शुड नॉट बी इन कंफर्ट जोन. माय क्वेश्चन इज, यू आर सेइंग वी शुड सर्व टिल द टाइम इट पिंचेस. वी शुड सर्व टिल द टाइम, लाइक चैरिटी ऑल्सो यू गिव एग्जाम्पल दैट यू शुड पिंच, दैट मेक्स एडवांसमेंट. एंड सिमिलरली यू सेड सर्विस ऑल्सो you should pinch. So in our practical understanding, how do we understand that, what is that pinching?
What is that pinching? So taking risk is good. Taking pinch is also good. But at the same time, you have to understand what is our capacity. We should not die also, no, by pinch. So once one of his Prabhupada disciple asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, I have an idea. Because we all have ideas, no? He said, I have an idea to go to the nightclub to preach Krishna consciousness. He said, why? He said, Prabhupada, getting people is very difficult. In the Western country, getting people to hear is very difficult. But getting people in nightclub is very easy. Everybody goes there. Said, why not is it, we go there and preach? Prabhupada said, okay, idea is good, but make sure you come back. So you have to understand our capacity. So different people have different kinds of capacity. Then who will determine that capacity? Your guru, your spiritual authority, they know your capacity. But whatever may be your capacity, we should not be in our comfort zone. If you can easily do 10, you should try to do 15. That's why Prabhupada said we should have service for 36 hours every day. What is this? 24 hours a day and 36 hours service. By this Prabhupada is explaining to us that we should not be in comfort zone. Some people say, Prabhuji, we have joined this movement to do chanting and hearing. So people don't have the idea of chanting. Chanting means glorifying the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Chanting doesn't mean always on the mala. Prabhuji, do this. No, I am in mala. So Prabhupada used to be very angry. So everything has time. Mala in the morning, daytime, seva. Some sannyasi came to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, sannyasi means always chant and hear, only giving class. Prabhupada said, follow me. So morning I give Bhagavatam class, afternoon I count money in the bank. So do both. Prabhupada was very blunt. We should know that service doesn't mean anything external. Service means we have to be connected. You are doing puja, you should be easily connected, no? But you are thinking, kab milega? Kab milega US visa, mai puja karunga America mein. If you think like that, then you are not connected with the Lord, you are connected with America. You understand? So you'll get America, no problem. In the same way, my Guru Maharaj, His Holiness Jayapada Goswami Maharaj, also was disturbed. Because he has the same idea. Sannyasi means giving class and preach. But he was ordered to build lotus building. Lotus building in my early days. So whole day busy in that, she wrote to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I am a sannyasi, I am supposed to study and preach, give class, but I am always spending time to build lotus building. He thought he'll get some nice answer. He got a heavy reply. So Prabhupada wrote, you are distinguishing between my books and my building, huh? My building and my books are the same. There is no difference between my building and my books. So building my building and reading my book is the same. How? Provided you have sambandha gyan. Sambandha gyan. I was also disturbed when I joined treasury. So I thought I'll preach, study same, everybody has that. So I was in treasury, keeping accounts, keeping cash, counting cash, all these things are happening early days. So I was disturbed, went to my Guru Maharaj. He said that you will experience presence of Krishna provided you have sambandha gyan. By counting money for Krishna, you can see His presence, provided you know this is Krishna's money. And when you do puja, you may not get the presence of Krishna if you don't do puja for Krishna. Even being pujari also will not be connected. By serving in treasury you can be connected. This all depends on our consciousness. Service has to be understood. Service means connection with Krishna. That is called devotional service. That is very, very important. Still, there is a difference. Some services you don't have to try, it's automatically a service. Sarup Siddha Bhakti and Arup Siddha Bhakti. I don't know if you have heard all this term. Sarup Siddha Bhakti means by constitution is bhakti. Just like offering puja to the Lord is bhakti. Chanting holy name is by itself is bhakti. Hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is bhakti. Cooking is bhakti or not? If you cook for the Lord, then is bhakti. Plucking flowers is bhakti or not? If you pluck flowers for Krishna, then is bhakti. Building is bhakti or not? If you build for Krishna, then is bhakti. But at a sadhaka level, we should do both Arop Siddha Bhakti and Swarup Siddha Bhakti. But at a transcendental platform, there is no difference between Swarup Siddha Bhakti and Arop Siddha Bhakti. For Prabhupada, everything is transcendental. But for us, because we don't have that kind of sambandha gyan, we don't have sambandha for Arop Siddha and we don't have sambandha for Swarup Siddha. Because we have no connection. That's why you have to make a balance. That's why as a sadhaka, we have to have a balance. For siddhas, everything is pure devotional service. Because whatever they do, is they do for the pleasure of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Okay? What was the question? Pinching. Over? Pinching should be there. Pinching from your temple commander, pinching from your temple president, pinching from your spiritual authority. If pinching is not there, it's dangerous. Okay?
Please, just now you tell that we are not able to see sambandh, so we have to balance both. So is there any need to work on sambandh also, like, or we need to have just balance, or is something we can do to develop that sambandh gyan, to have that thing, how we can develop that?
Doing both.
By balancing only we will get this sambandh gyan.
If you don't do balance, what will happen? You should ask that. Prabhupada said, if you do only sadhana and not do seva, you become lazy. And if you only do seva and not sadhana, you become crazy. ISKCON is not meant for lazy and crazy people. Okay. That's why morning sadhana, whole day seva. Okay. Any other question? So we'll end here. Prem Harinam Prabhu. सगंतरा श्रीमद भागवतम की जय समवेत गौर भक्तवृंद की जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल।